In this video, I'd like to show you how to upload digital images of student artwork to the Artsonia online web gallery. Now, before we even log in, it's important to make sure we've taken our images from the scanner or from a digital camera and placed them in a spot that we can find them easily when we go to upload and publish. I find it easiest to create a folder on the desktop of the computer just labeled for Artsonia. That way I can take the images and place them in, upload them, and remove them as necessary. So if we open up this folder, you can see here are the three images we're going to upload, and we're going to publish at least one. So if we open the browser once again, if you go to the login for the teachers on Artsonia, you can type in the username and password that I've provided you, and then click login. We're at the teacher dashboard. It'll label the school and teacher name and give us a whole bunch of different options to mess with. Now we want to go underneath the red line at the top and click on Upload Artwork. Now here's our uploading tools. There's the Flash Uploader, Java Uploader, and there's also a nice iPhone app that works really, really well. But for our case here, we're always going to use the Flash Uploader. Here's our new window for the Flash Uploader, and we're going to click on Browse to find the images that we looked at earlier. So just to be sure, I'm going to click on the desktop, find my Artsonia folder, and double-click it to open. At this point, you can hit Control-A to highlight all of the images, or you can simply click and drag to select all images. And then we hit Open. Each of your images will go into the Flash Uploader as a little thumbnail. When you hover over them with your cursor, you can either rotate them or delete any unnecessary ones that might have gotten into the mix. Once we see all the images that we need, we're going to click Upload and wait for the Flash Uploader to do its work. At the bottom, you'll see a little progress meter telling you that they're preparing and eventually uploading. We only have three images here, so it should go fairly quickly, and then your screen will actually change. All right, it's uploaded and it's ready to publish. Now, if you're doing a full stack and a huge group of work, you can click on Publish, and it will give you them one at a time to assign to a grade level and a gallery. But for the sake of this demo, we're just going to go through one piece in particular. So I'm going to take this one here and click on it, and it'll take me to my publishing page. Now we simply start at the top and work our way down, and then we can edit and finally completely publish. We're first going to start by selecting the grade level for that particular class or student. If the artist is already in the school roster, we're going to click here in the drop-down menu and type the first two letters of their last name, which will get you closer to finding their actual screen name, and then you select. For safety and security reasons, I am not going to click here to protect the last names of my students. So we're simply going to pretend this was a student not in the roster and going to add it completely new. So we're going to make up a name so it doesn't accidentally show some last names of my students. For right now, I'm going to leave this missing until parents can approve. But if you know that your parents are approved and the district says that it's okay, you can grant the permission, meaning that the artwork will be available on the web to view, not just to parents. As we scroll down, we need to organize an exhibit. If it's a new exhibit, we're going to click on Create, and then type in the name of the new exhibit. If it is adding to one that currently exists, we'll find the drop-down menu and the exhibits for this year, and select. Artwork info is optional, and if there's time, you can do an artist statement with the students. We're then going to click Edit the image. We have a selection of tools here to rotate and to autofix. It is generally preferred to hit autofix on every image. This will change the color and optimize it. You can also then click and drag to select parts of the image and hit crop. As long as everything looks okay at this point, we're going to select publish. We now must allow one business day, or roughly 24 hours, for the images to be looked over by Artsonia to make sure there are no names or pictures of the students themselves. And then we're done.